Your eyes, when you open your eyes and say, thank you, Jesus. Be still and know I am God.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Prepare yourselves to receive, because he has a great message for you. Amen.
Amen.
We always trying to figure out who it's for. It's for you. It's for me. Go like this. It's for me. Amen. All those of you that are joining us, we welcome you to New Beginnings Church of the Big Bend here in Marfa, Texas. Pastor Jose and Patricia, we want to welcome you and just invite you to come join us and feel free to open up and let God bless you. Amen. He wants to bless you. He wants to encourage you.
Yes.
And also, he wants to correct us. Once in a while, he needs to, you know, shake us up and dust us off.
All
you know,
right.
Conviction. If there's conviction there, let him straighten you out, whatever you need, okay? We all need it in different ways, but he wants to love us, amen? He's a loving and compassionate God, amen? So praise God. Woo, God is good,
amen?
All the time, amen? I'm excited, church. As Pastor Pat said, sometimes we have to prepare ourselves by quieting our minds, because the Bible says we fight a spiritual battle, and your mind is going 100 miles an hour.
Yeah.
All these things that I have planned already. Let me see, what time the Cowboys come on? What time's my team playing? When are we going to quiet? What are we going to eat? We got to quiet these things. I wish the speaker would hurry up. It's God's timing, not my timing.
Amen.
So we got to quiet ourselves so he can speak to us. Be still and know that I am God.
Yes.
How are we going to get to know him? By spending time with him. And most of the time, we need to be quiet. Amen. He wants to bless you. Amen. He wants to bless you. So praise God. Join with me, church. Let me grab my sword first. Where's yours? Grab one or grab the one next to you. Amen. Praise God. This is my Bible. I am what it says I am. I have what it says I am. I can do what it says I can do. Today, I'll be taught the word of God. I'm holy convinced. My mind's alert. My spirit is receptive. And I'll never be the same. My mind is alert. Amen.
Praise God.
So, I'm going to settle that.
Yeah.
Amen. I'm going to settle that. What about me? Brother, she says this is for Oscar. Forget about Pastor.
Yours is in the cup.
So praise God.
Amen.
Church, prepare yourselves every day. You know, every day before you go out, we prepare ourselves. Don't run into the world and have an accident. You're going to crash because the world is going to tear you up without him. We need him on a daily basis. If you don't have him, you're fighting a losing battle. We fight a spiritual battle, and you can't do it in the flesh. You can't deal with it in the flesh.
Right.
You got to get in the Word of God, spend time with him, and just give yourself a spiritual pep rally with him. And just let him know, Lord, I need you. I need your strength. I need you all over me.
Amen.
I'm going somewhere to happen for somebody. Somebody's going to get saved today.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. He wants to use every one of you. Don't say, well, you know, I'm not ready for that. Well, get yourself ready. Get in there with him. You know, he says, I've called you. I've qualified you. You've got everything you need to do what I've called you to do.
Amen.
So what are you waiting for? The world to qualify you?
Uh-uh.
If God's qualified you, forget what the world says.
Yes.
You know what the world's going to say?
Uh-huh.
You're not good enough.
That's it.
You're never going to be up to what we call you to be.
Mm.
But you are up to what he's called you to be.
Yes. Amen.
Amen. Remember, the enemy comes to what? Steal, kill, and destroy. You got to be strong in him.
Amen.
Otherwise, you're going down.
Yeah.
So, hey, we're just being nice. You got to get into him so he can get into you.
Yes.
You know, when you get the word in you, all the fears and all these other fleshly things are going to come out.
Uh-huh.
And faith is going to come in. So when you start to step in, you're taking steps of faith.
Yes.
And you're going to come out of your closet. You're going to come out of your boat. You're going to come out of your box.
Mm-hmm. Come on.
And it's time to move on, you know. Time to cut them roots of the world off of you and start growing roots in him.
Amen.
Amen. Because you can do some things through him.
All
things through him.
Amen.
Lord, I'm with you. I've got my power behind me. I've got my power with me.
Yes.
The Holy Spirit is in me.
Yes.
God is in me. Jesus is in me. I can do all things through
all
him.
Things.
Amen. I'm excited, church. I don't know about you, but on a daily basis, be excited, because you know what? Because I'm on a mission for him.
Yes.
And I'm on a mission to win, not to lose.
That's right.
It's time we start speaking the problem. and start speaking the answer. You have the word in you. You just got to release it. You know, the word will work if you release the word.
Yes.
It's in there, but it's not going to do anything unless you let it out.
That's right.
And go out and do what God has called it to do.
Amen.
Welcome, brother.
Praise God.
Praise God. Amen.
Amen.
I'm excited, church. You get excited?
Yes.
Yes.
Well, at this time, what I want to do is I want to introduce our guest speaker, Oscar. And what a blessing he is. Amen. God's using him in a mighty way.
Yes.
He reaches people that some of us are not called to be there.
No, boy.
Amen. He goes everywhere. The byways, everywhere. Amen. He has a prison ministry. He has a jail ministry. And God is using him mightily.
Glory,
and
yes.
Last week we talked to him. God spoke to him and let him know, I am pleased with you. And I have called you. And I've got you where I want you.
Yes.
Amen. God has got you where he wants you.
Yes.
Amen.
That's
and he
right.
wants to use every one of you.
Yeah.
So don't say, well, I'm just going to kick back.
Uh-uh.
If you notice, when a team plays, everybody wants to get in the game. He's called us to be participators, not spectators.
That's right.
Nobody called you to spectate. Nobody's called you to judge.
That's right.
Nobody's called you to say, well, you know, that person needs to get clean.
Uh-uh.
No, that's God's job.
Yes.
Our job is to take the word to the lost world, the negative world.
Yes.
The critical world. Amen.
Oh,
we bring the good news, not the sad news, not the bad news.
That's right.
Amen. Praise God.
Thank you.
You're the lighthouse for him. You're the shining light for this dark world. Amen.
Amen.
So see yourself that way. See yourself the way he sees you.
Yes.
Amen.
Praise.
So Brother Oscar, come on up.
Yes.
Amen.
Right.
Hallelujah. Mighty man of God, anointed of God, called of God. Amen.
Amen.
And every time he brings the word, it just blesses us. So let it bless you. Amen.
Amen.
You say, well, that wasn't for me. And you know what? We've said it before, but pray as he ministers, because the enemy wants to steal, kill, and destroy.
And destroy. Yeah.
Okay, so let it in. Amen. Hallelujah. Welcome, brother. God bless you.
Thank you.
Bless you. It's all yours, brother. Take it on. It is always...
You didn't put him on the mic.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm good.
Hold on just a minute.
It is always an honor to be here. God bless you. You're such an inspiration.
Yes.
For such a time as this.
Mm-hmm.
All of you, the worship team, I was cheering with somebody. I said, man, love their singing. It just gets me going. And all of you get me going. There's a little boy that sits right here in the drums. Yes. I was probably eating alone this morning, but I see that smiling face. I said, oh my God, thank you. Yes. Yes, I'm fixing to get on the airplane, so y'all are on board. Praise God this morning. Hallelujah. It's all right to say hallelujah this morning.
Yeah.
Because God is moving from the ordinary to the extraordinary.
Yes, yes he is.
From the natural to the supernatural every day in a mighty, powerful way.
Amen.
I love this song that says that y'all were singing, be still and know that I'm God.
Mm-hmm.
And I was sharing with y'all, that I might have shared with y'all last time that I was here, that I had a message for Chiringo Ranch titled, take a chill pill, be still, and know that I am God.
Wow.
Amen. And I need to take those chill pills right now. I need to. He stretches his hands from the heavens and gives me a chill pill. Because it's easy to be distracted by circumstance, by everything else going pretty wacko out there right now. But praise be to God.
Amen.
And the same peace be still.
Amen.
I was at the jail last Sunday night. After I left here, and I went up to the jail on Sunday evening. Anyway, it was such a blessing because I munched on that message myself too.
Amen.
The title of the message was, he heals the brokenhearted.
Yes.
And he bandages their wounds.
Yes.
And yesterday I was riding around, said, Lord, where is your message? And I rode around back and forth, and I... You know, trying to see if it feels in the clouds or if it feels out there in the mountain somewhere. I said, Lord, because he reveals himself in such a beautiful way.
Yeah.
And it's really, I am just so happy to see each and every one of you all here. Love you. God bless you. And I ask your continued prayers because we battle not against flesh and blood, spirits, and principalities.
Yeah.
I'll tell you. And I had to take some smart water this morning, right? You know, I said, the only way to get going is by taking smart water. Praise be to God for the word that endureth forever.
Forever.
Hallelujah. And I said, Lord, what is the message? Because I decide not to come in here and throw off a few crumbs at you and say, wait a minute, what was that all about? No way. And I'm going to minister in both languages and nobody walks out the door and say, oh, well, I didn't understand it. So I'm used to doing this at the jail. And, you know, for such a time as this, I've seen grown men cry. So feel free to cry this morning if you need to cry.
Amen.
Yo he escuchado hombres llorando porque los hombres verdaderos lloran. Y los hombres verdaderos oran. Because real men cry and real men pray.
Yes.
We can't go around with this superficial attitude that me. God is, you know, coming to take out that hardness of heart and that stony heart and put a heart of flesh in there.
Yes.
Praise be to God. Hallelujah. And I was asking him and I said, Lord, and I went into a time of prayer and fasting because I want the Spirit to move in my life and each and every one. Me puse en un tiempo de ayuno para que se manifieste el poder y que se venga la palabra y a toque nuestra mente, nuestro espíritu, nuestro cuerpo. That the word would touch our spirit, our heart, our soul, and our mind.
Yes.
Because I need more of it. I'm not sitting on top of a cloud and, hey, what are y'all doing down there? No way. I go through these areas, these struggles. We have family that needs God.
Yes.
Tenemos familia que necesitan de Dios.
Yes.
Tenemos vecinos que necesitan de Dios. We have friends. We have neighbors. We have people that need God right now in such a way.
Yes.
People are distracted in so many ways.
Yes.
But then there is God.
Yeah.
For whoever wants God.
Amen.
To submit to Him in such a way.
Amen.
And as I shared last time, no matter what they call us, you bunch of holy rollers, that's all right.
That's
we're
going
to roll over the place.
Right.
And we're going to receive the blessings of God in such a way. We want more. And the only way to move further is to be have the nutrition.
Mm.
You know what the enemy wants? He's a malnourished Christian.
That
we lack. But the word of God says, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not lack.
Amen.
Then we overflow. See, in the overflow, we can have an impact.
Amen.
Cuando hay abundancia de espíritu y de palabra, podemos tener un impacto. Y si estamos nomás creyendo, pero no viviendo, es imposible tener un impacto. If we decide to just believe in God but not live for Him, it is impossible to have an impact.
Yes.
Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
And praise be to God.
Yes.
Relaying with a brother, pastor, and Pastor Jose and his wife, and my condolences and my love to each and every one of y'all and everything going on. And we praise God for that He is there. The Hebrew word says Jehovah Shammah.
Yes.
That God is there. Que Dios está ahí en estas batallas, en estos ataques del enemigo. In every target of the enemy, God is there. So we're calling Him this morning, throughout the day, and the week, and the days ahead, and the years ahead. Hay que clamarle que venga y que trate con nuestras vidas y que trate con nuestros hijos. That He deals with our families, that He deals with our lives, that He deals with our kids.
Yes.
In every way.
Amen.
Hallelujah. If you open your the word into 1 Timothy this morning, Primera de Timoteo, capítulo 4, y versículo 1, 1 Timothy chapter 4, and verse 1, hallelujah.
Thank you.
Yes.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Yes. This is always an honor to share the word. I love the ministry at the jail, and it keeps me in prayer for direction. Say, God, what do you want me to do? We go through those areas. You want me to continue at the jail? You know, after 6 years, I did resign the jail, and the Lord pulled me by the ears. You probably noticed my ears are pretty long. He keeps pulling me. I said, where do you think you're going?
Oh,
hallelujah.
Yes.
After 7.5 years there at the jail, I continue to go.
Yes.
Because I am blessed by that.
Amen.
And I declare the power of God over them, over my life,
hallelujah,
and over my children.
That's
in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
1 Timothy chapter 4, Primera de Timoteo capítulo 4, versículo 1, verse 1. And this is what the word of God is saying to the city, to the nation, and all nations.
Yes.
Now, the Spirit speaketh expressly that in the latter times some shall depart from the faith, giving heed to seducing spirits and doctrines of devils, speaking lies and hypocrisy, having their own conscience seared with a hot iron, forbidding to marry and commanding to abstain from meats which God hath created to be received with thanksgiving.
Yes.
For them which he believe, which believe and know the truth.
Yes.
This is very powerful right here.
Yes.
This is the word of God. He says, for it is sanctified by the word of God in prayer. Dice la palabra de Dios. Pero el Espíritu dice claramente que en los postreros tiempos algunos apostarán de la fe, escuchando espíritus engañadores y doctrinas de demonios, por la hipocresía de mentirosos que, teniendo cauterizada la conciencia, prohibirán casarse y mandarán abstenerse de alimentos que Dios crió que con acción de gracias participasen de ellos los creyentes y los que han conocido la verdad. Muchos han conocido la verdad, pero han abierto la puerta a toda clase de revoltura, como quien dice, toda clase de capirotada que no le agrada a Dios. Many have known the truth, and many have departed from the truth,
right,
because there is a fascination out there.
Yeah.
And one of the biggest fascinations is intellectualism.
Oh wow.
Woo, it sounds good. I want that. But that at the end of the day, it was very shallow.
Right.
He had nothing to do with God.
Right.
God has blessed us with an imagination. And that is awesome. It's all right. Nothing against intellectualism, as long as it's tied in with the power of God, with the principles and the values. Nada contra la inteligencia, nomás que esté añadida con el poder de Dios, los principios y los valores, el mensaje de plan de salvación. Gloria a su nombre. Dice aquí que en los postreros días, dice ahí, see, the Spirit speaketh expressly, because he's going to reveal everything that is going on in your lives, individually and corporately, for such a time as this. To speak in lies and hypocrisy, he said, giving it unto doctrines of devils. And there's a word that not many like to hear nowadays. Oh boy, there you go. There you go with that word. And I, un día le dije esa palabra a una persona. Y yo, ay, ¿qué quiere decir eso? ¿Qué quiere decir chamuco? ¿Qué quiere decir eso? Right. You know, we know what all that's up there. Because we know the word. We know that there's a destruction, but then there's a power of God. He wants to cover us with his precious blood.
Yeah.
Nos quiere cubrir con su sangre preciosa, porque hay muchos que se están apartando. Many are taken off into all these wild ideas that are out there. See, it is here in verse 7, versículo 7 dice, desecha las fábulas profanas y de viejas ejercítate para la piedad, dice, but refuse profane and all wise fables and exercise the silver thereunto unto godliness.
Yes.
Versículo 8 dice, porque el ejercicio corporal para poco es provechoso, pero la piedad para todo aprovecha, pues tiene promesa de esta vida presente y la de venidera. For bodily exercise profiteth little, but godliness is profitable unto all things, having promise of the life that now is, and of that which is to come.
Amen.
We see the importance of the Spirit.
Thank you.
We see everything that is going on for such a time as this, because many are running out the door for that fascination. The New Age movement wants to lure a lot of people into that. See, the New Age movement wants to have people thinking that this secular humanism is near the center of it all. And the world revolves around you. I said, yeah, sure. We've seen a lot of big leaders that thought they were at the center of it all without God, and we see them go down.
Yes.
It's in the Bible. King Nebuchadnezzar, King Belshazzar, and a lot of them every day.
Yes, yes.
And it's speaking right here that many have given heed to seducing spirits.
Yes.
Si han dado, han caído en la trampa del enemigo de espíritus engañadores. See, if there's no discernment, there's going to be more deception. Si no hay discernimiento, hay más engaño. Y cuando comienzan a ocurrir cosas, comienzan a ocurrir. Porque una puerta abierta derrota se viene todo encima. Because an open door for the enemy is an open door for everything else.
Right.
Spirit after spirit after spirit, depression, fear, and everything else. Self-defeating, as I mentioned this time, the spirit of hypochondria. Oh, what's going on with me? Woo! What am I? What's happening with me? And there's nothing. Oh, then you look in the mirrors. Oh, am I turning into a werewolf? That's not the case. The enemy is very deceiving.
Yes.
Oh, praise be to God.
Yes.
See, and this seducing spirits are luring many. And the title of the message today, so it's running around, is thought, well, it'll be applicable for the area. Meanwhile, back at the ranch. See, one of us, some of us, as fathers and mothers and parents, are going to have to take care of that ranch.
Yeah.
We're going to have to stay in prayer.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to have to stay in fasting. Mm-hmm. Vamos a tener que procurar y cuidar el rancho, cuidar las bendiciones de Dios, la herencia de Dios. See, because we are of the covenant of Abraham.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Therefore, the inheritance of Abraham is ours.
Yes.
If the enemy comes to steal, kill, and destroy, see, he would like to take that ranch and all the chickens and everything else.
Oh, yeah.
Man, he would like to turn things upside down. Quisiera derrotar todo, llevarse las gallinas y sumarse a ese cuervo en el entregañero y llevarse los huevos también. Pero gloria a Dios, que en un pueblo en autoridad.
Yeah.
A people in authority will not allow that.
Yeah.
See, every believer has got to know about their identity in Christ,
right.
To know about authority.
Yes.
Todo creyente tiene que saber de su identificación. ¿Quién somos en Cristo? Para poder conocer la autoridad que tenemos. Yeah. We can know the authority. Hallelujah. There's so much out there that tries to distract the people. But then there's a power of God, the Word of God, and it doesn't matter. We have church, like Sister Patricia said right here, you know, in here, out by the creek, out there at the edge of town, or wherever we, you know, just continue for such a time as this.
Amen.
And I shared with someone the other day, so you're going to go to Marfa this Sunday? I said, yeah, I need to go up there and get some ammunition.
Yeah.
And you all have some good ammunition here. I like that. That's why I keep coming, and I thank you, Scott, for bringing me, because ammunition for the warfare and the blessings that are here.
Amen.
And this is very important, that all this that is going on is going on and on, because he's not going to stop. El enemigo no va a parar. Tenemos que vivir adelante, fuerte en ayuno y en la palabra y en oración.
Mm.
In prayer and fasting for such a time as this. Mm. En el libro de Lucas, capítulo 15, from the book of Luke, chapter 15 and verse 10, see, all these ideas are going to be floating around. And well, there's a lot of them. I heard a person say the other day, oh, well, these laws of attraction and blah, blah, blah. Yeah, sure.
Uh-huh.
Attract everything my way. And what about God, you know?
Uh-huh.
There's all these philosophy, all these ideas that do not conform to the will of God.
Right.
And one of the things, una de las cosas que había mencionado la última vez que estuve aquí, lo que se han mezclado. The tempered and the untempered mortar. And I had mentioned that last time. So there's a mixture of all these thoughts. See, that's the purpose of the enemy. San Lucas, capítulo 15, the book of Luke, chapter 15, and verse 10. Hallelujah. And praise be to God in every way. Everything that is doing in my life and all of us, in every way. This message, I give God the glory and honor. I said, Lord, I want to deliver your word. Just let it be you in every way, you know. And I just, you know, when I used to write for the paper, I said, Lord, you know, I'd be up there 2-3 in the morning and write. I said, Lord, let it be you. Anoint this message, because I don't want to be throwing out there everything else but God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Capítulo 15, versículo 10. Versículo 11, perdón. I'll just start at 10. Yes, 10 is fine. The Word of God says, la palabra de Dios dice, así os digo que hay gozo delante de los ángeles de Dios por un pecador que se arrepiente. Likewise, I say unto you that there is joy in the presence of the angels of God over one sinner that repenteth.
Amen.
And this is a story that's very important. So I started, but I'll just give it a title, meanwhile back at the ranch, mientras ahí del rancho, dice. También dijo, versículo 11, un hombre tenía dos hijos. It says right here, a certain man had two sons, Y el menor de ellos dijo a su padre: Padre, dame la parte de los bienes que me corresponde. Y le repartió los bienes. No muchos días después, juntándolo todo el hijo menor, se fue lejos una provincia apartada. Y allí desperdició sus bienes viviendo perdidamente. And the younger then said unto his father, Give me the portion of the goods that falleth to me. And he divided unto them his living. And not many days, verse 13, after the younger son gathered all together and took his journey into a far country, and there wasted his substance with righteous living in rebellion, you know, just way out of line. Well, I've got this money, I've got this nice Corvette, I got this nice horse, I'm going to get all over town, and I'm going to, you know, it's all my world. I'm going to go into every saloon, and I'm going to have a blast. The enemy looks for those opportunities to get us into ego.
Yeah.
Well, nobody's going to stop me. Mm. Well, I heard about a relative a couple of days ago that said, nobody's going to tell me to stop drinking. Yo oí una opinión, unas palabras de un familiar que dijo, nadie me va a decir que pare tomar. Y la oportunidad del enemigo está ahí. Porque si no declaramos algo bueno, lo que es poder y vida, if we don't declare what is power and what is life and what is the word of God, guess what the enemy is, guess who's going to declare something else?
Yeah.
The enemy.
Yeah.
So this dude, this, you know, this ranch hand, the son of this big rancher or whatever, decided to head out. See, that's why it is important that we stay in tune, in prayer, and fasting in the Word.
Amen.
No matter how much they criticize us, God,
that's right.
Man,
that's right.
You're still praying for him, yes? And you're still praying for her, yes?
Yeah.
¿Tú estás orando por él? No tiene esperanza, si tiene esperanza. That person has no hope. Oh, yes, he does.
Yeah,
I tell the men at the jail that are doing heroin, that they've done meth, they've done everything else, that God is dealing with his hearts. He wants to bless them.
Yeah.
Los quiere bendecir, los quiere librar.
Amen.
Los quiere sacar por delante. He wants us to rise above the circumstance.
Yes, he does.
Because it is right here in verse 14. And he has spent it all, there arose a mighty famine in the land, and he began to be in want.
Oh,
the problems. Y cuando todo lo hubo malgastado, vino una gran hambre en aquella provincia, y comenzó a faltarle. Ahí es donde está el problema. See, once there is that lack, there is that hunger, people will go and the enemy will immediately come with all seducing spirits, with every other false doctrine about the plan of salvation.
Yes.
And there's plenty of it in Marfa, in Alpine, Fort Davis, all the way to the Permian Basin, from one end of the country to the other. But the enemy would want to lure everybody into everything else but God.
Right.
And then it's just really something, because it's he would fain have filled his belly with a husk that the swine did eat, and no man gave unto him. Está terrible la cosa, dice. Y fue y se arrimó a uno de los ciudadanos de aquella tierra, el cual envió a su hacienda para que apacentase cerdos. Y deseaba llenar su vientre de las algarrobas que comían los cerdos, pero nadie le daba. You know, here we are, here's this guy, comes to a big ranch, and there's a strategy of the enemy to take the inheritance away from the blessing, to carry on the ranch, to start with their kids.
Yeah.
But there's power in the blood.
Yes, there is.
La sangre de Cristo tiene poder.
Hallelujah.
Y este fue una vida desordenada, y deseaba, dice, las algarrobas. He desired even the husk. Not even the tamale, just the husk. Isn't that terrible? Not even the tamale. It's like, to be out there in a world of lack, in a world of struggle, and many have put themselves into this area.
Yes,
God says, I have come that you might have life and have it more abundantly. See, he's got a buffet of his word.
Yes.
He's got a buffet of blessings.
Yes.
But the moment we limit God, well, the enemy has a heyday.
Oh, yeah.
You know, here he was even craving the husk. Like, oh my God, and I forgot to pick up a bag of husk at the store and just bring it as a visual. Está tremendo porque comenzamos a dar esa oportunidad al enemigo. And when that hunger is there, there's the psychics, vienen los adivinos, there's the new age movement, there's the drug culture, there's everything else, but God saying, come this way. Ven para acá, aquí te damos algo. Y a mí me han dicho varios, tú has pasado por mucho, échate un traguito de tequila ya, vamos. No way. And they told me, some have come along, oh, you've been through a lot, let me give you a shot of tequila. Yeah. No way. Stay back. Because it's really pronounced tequila.
Yeah. Oh, tequila!
Keep drinking and it's going to kill you.
Oh,
yeah, that's the bottom line. Hallelujah. And it says right here, and he continues to say, dice, volviendo en sí, dijo, ¿cuántos jornaleros en casa de mi padre tienen abundancia de pan?
Yes, sir.
Y yo aquí perezco de hambre.
Come on.
And home he came to himself, he said, how many hired servants and my father's have bread enough to spare, and I perish with hunger.
Mm-hmm.
Oh my God, you know, there's all these wrong steaks in the freezer at the ranch, and everything else, ribeyes and everything else. And, you know, there's all this word, and here we are living in a in lack.
Yes.
Because we've given him the opportunity. We've taken out and we jumped on that horse. And remember what I said about that horse?
Yeah.
That horse has a name.
Yeah.
It's called pride.
Oh my gosh.
Hemos brincado en ese caballo y hemos salido del rancho. Y ese caballo tiene nombre, perdón, se llama orgullo. And when we jump on that horse, we're all high and mighty, yes.
Oh, yeah.
Those boots and everything else but God.
Oh, come on.
Todo, pero sin Dios. Y viene la derrota. Y viene la derrota en familias, en hogares, y se pierden los ranchos. Tiene que estar alguien en oración, en ayuno. Así como padres. I said, just like fathers, like mothers, we better stay tuned and we better stay focused in prayer and fasting. We better stay in the Word.
Yes.
We better, you know, if there's places that are not allowing the Spirit to move, we better go where the Spirit is moving for such a time as this.
Right.
Because all these wild ideas that, oh no, that's not happening anymore. Well, Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today and forever. Aquellos que te dicen que no, esos milagros, esos, Dios no, eso es algo de tiempo atrás. No, Jesucristo es el mismo ayer y hoy y por los siglos. Y sigue derrotando y sigue echando fuera demonios. See, he brings deliverance as well.
Yes.
I remember back in 77 when there was a mighty move of the Spirit there in Alpine. There were people from one end of the floor to the other in this old gym, the Centennial Gym. And oh, what an awesome place. It was, God was moving. All this stuff that needed to go. Dios estaba manifestando poderosamente, trayendo liberación. Y aquí dice, versículo 18, verse 18, me levantaré e iré a mi padre y le diré, Padre, he pecado contra el cielo y contra ti. I will arise and go to my father, verse 18, and I will say unto him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and before thee. See, we got to go through those areas. We got to go through those. Father, I have sinned. Forgive me of my sins. I repent. If not, we fall into that category. One of the messages that I had a while back was a case of denial and deflection.
Oh, boy.
And there's a lot of it out there. No, there's nothing wrong with it. It's you.
Yeah.
It's that situation.
Yeah.
I was born on the other side of the tracks. That's why I've been going through all this. I went through this and I went through that. Yes, we went through this and we went through that. But what's the excuse for not serving him?
Yeah.
¿Cuál es la excusa que se sigue perdiendo todo? Gloria a tu nombre, Señor. Hallelujah. And he arose and came to his father. Remember, there is that step of faith. Because God is not pulling anybody by the ears.
That's right.
He arose and went to his father.
Yes.
Fue a su padre. Dios no estaba para jalarle los sentidos, las orejas. Vente, me vas a servir. Oh, praise be to God. And this is really awesome. Versículo 20, verse 20. y levantándose vino a su padre, y cuando aún estaba lejos, lo vio su padre y fue movido a misericordia, y corrió y se echó sobre su cuello y le besó. Aleluya. Gloria a Dios. And he arose and he came to his father. Verse 20. And when he was yet a great way off, his father saw him and had compassion, and he ran and fell on his neck and kissed him.
Yes.
See, the father is right before us.
Yes.
Come back. You've been distracted by the situations. You've been distracted by circumstance. You've been distracted by your enemies, by false doctrines, by everything else. You've been distracted by your addictions. Come back before it's too late. Come back to the ranch here.
Amen.
Come back and let's have a feast. Let's be blessed.
Amen. Praise God.
And it's really awesome. One of the things that I always like is that, Lord, teach me. We have to humble ourselves.
Yes.
Say, Lord, teach me. For such a time as this, and everything going on in our lives. And it says he ran to the father. He says, his son said, Father, I have sinned against thee. He pecado contra ti. He said, y contra ti, contra el cielo. He said, no soy digno de ser llamado tu hijo. Somos dignos. We are. See, the enemy has whispered into many into the ear, oh no, you're a lost case. What are you doing over there at the church? What are you doing out there? They yell a lot. They jump a lot. You're going to go wacko.
Oh, Jesus.
Oh, hallelujah. Let's go wacko for Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Let's go wacko for the power of God.
Yes.
For the salvation of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Diga lo que digan los burlones y los criticones. Y gloria a su nombre. Hallelujah. Versículo 22. Pero el Padre dijo a sus siervos, sacar el mejor vestido y vestirle, y poner un anillo en su mano y calzado en sus pies. But the father, verse 22, said to his servants, bring forth the best robe and put it on him, and put a ring on his hand, and shoes on his feet. On his feet. This room for the ranch, you know, boots.
Yeah.
You know, ostrich, what do you want? Ostrich? Is there a skin? What kind of boots do you want? Ostrich.
Praise God.
God is awesome. God is so awesome, because us men, we like certain kind of boots, and sometimes we want them all the way to the knee, and you know, it's just really something. You'll take us straight into some of these big boot companies. Okay, take a peek.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Versículo 22, pero el padre dijo a sus siervos, sacar el mejor vestido. Pero el enemigo quisiera traernos a punta de garras. Quisiera traernos derrotados, y como quien dice, con esa cara y banano. Y se oye tremendo, pero así me han dicho varios. Dice, mira, ¿qué está pasando? Mira, dije, no, mira, endereza, de que es aquel gozo y el poder de Dios. Quisiera traernos tristes, derrotados, deprimidos, pero Dios no lo va a permitir. Pasamos tiempos tremendos. We go through some terrible times. You know, we went through depression, went through divorce, went through this, went through that. But God is saying, hey, come on, don't stay out there. Don't
That's
be distracted.
Right.
Don't be distracted by those circumstances.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. And God works in so many ways. And,
yes, he
and
does.
One of my brothers was in town from Vegas and said, I got you a pair of boots. I said, oh my God.
No!
Dios tocando grandemente. Sometimes it gets like, oh my God, these boots, I can't even fit my soles anymore. Dios es grande y poderoso. Dice el versículo 23, verse 23, and bring hither the fatted calf and kill it, and let us eat and be merry.
Amen.
We forget about ourselves. We forget that God says, I've come that we might have life and have it more abundantly.
Yes.
The enemy would want to keep us in malnourished spiritually and physically and personally in all these areas. But we call on God that He bless His people.
Yes.
That He shield us against the lies of the enemy.
Amen.
Because there's a lot of them out there every day. Amen. Dice el versículo 24, dice 23, y traer el becerro gordo y matarlo y comemos y hagamos fiesta. Fiesta en el nombre de Jesús. Alabanza, una fiesta así. Con todo lo demás que no le agrada a Dios, no. Una fiesta en el Espíritu, una danza danzan en el espíritu.
Yeah.
And these fiestas dancing in the spirit.
Yeah.
Allowing the spirit of God to move, being blessed, nothing else but God.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. Yeah.
Because a lot of people say, oh, fiesta, let's go down there, let's get everything, let's buy everything else. No way. No way. Mm. Everything else that is deteriorating the spirit, soul, mind, and body, no way. Mm. But you gotta say it every day, no way. Praise God, hallelujah.
Man.
Y aquí dice el versículo 24, porque este mi hijo muerto era y ha revivido y había perdido y es hallado y comenzaron a regocijarse. Verse 24, the word of God says, for this my son was dead. And he's alive again. He was lost and he's found. And they began to be merry. Hallelujah.
Yes.
See, those areas of the enemy, we want to keep people in confusion, keep them lost, keep them in that snare.
Yeah.
Pero hay que orar en el nombre de Jesús que sean libres, porque la palabra de Dios dice que donde el Espíritu de Dios está, hay libertad. Because the Spirit of God says it where the Word of God says that where the Spirit of God is,
yes, there's
liberty. Hallelujah.
Praise
See,
God.
He was dead. He was dead spiritually. He was just a goner. And you were like, oh my God, if I could just grab those husks from a pig, I could eat.
Yeah.
What a terrible moment in time.
Yes.
And that's the enemy. Quisiera el enemigo que agarrando las hojas de los tamales nomás cuando vayan al rancho da todo el tamal. Up there at the ranch, they got everything. Everything, because within God we are more than conquerors. We are blessed, and we will continue to be blessed in every way.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus. See, he was everything was gone. I mean, could you imagine? You know, there's many out there right now. They're depressed, they're dead, and thinking there's no hope. And this can happen even within churches sometimes. We don't allow the Spirit of God to move. The Word of God. The enemy say, no, don't. Don't get too excited. That's what the enemy said. No, chill out. Don't say, that's enough. That's not enough. We want to overflow in the Spirit and the Word in every way.
Amen.
We want to, just be alive in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Ser vivos en el nombre de Jesús.
Yes.
Tener un impacto en nuestros hijos para que no se pierda ese rancho. Mm. Que no se pierda la herencia que Dios nos ha dado por medio de Abraham. That we don't lose the inheritance that God has given us. See, remember, we are the covenant of Abraham.
Yes.
And the inheritance of Abraham, once again, is ours. Hallelujah.
Praise
and God is moving in such a way.
Yes, he is.
See, it's right there. You know, there's another interpretation that I was reading this night, and I won't go into the depthness of this. I was going through some Hebrew, Greek translations. Anyway, when he tried to fill his belly with those husks. See, we want to reach out for every other idea.
Yes, come on.
And just to fill me. And it's still not full. We're still not full because it's not going to fill us at all.
That's right.
At the end of the day, we're still hungry.
Mm-hmm.
Said, oh my God, what was that all about?
Mm.
You know, the Word of God talks about clouds without rain and wells without water.
Mm.
And they're out there.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
They're out there, I know yes, sin agua, hay nubes sin agua, hasta cuando el Espíritu de Dios se comienza a manifestar. Entonces vemos la lluvia sobre el rancho. Oh, hallelujah, then we're going to see the rain over the ranch and everybody's going to be, the blessings of God. Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
See, these things, meanwhile back at the ranch, that's what we're going to have to stay positioned in prayer.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to have to stay day in and day out, no matter what they say about us.
Yes.
Every day. In the book of Matthew 24.
Yes.
In the book of Matthew 24 and verse 3. Libro de San Mateo, versículo 24 y versículo 3. Capítulo 24 y versículo 3. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
And praise be to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, that we are allowing God to move from the natural to the supernatural, the ordinary to the extraordinary in such a beautiful way.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Let's just have the ribeye of the message every day, the blessings of God in every way. Hallelujah. Matthew 24 and verse 3. Gloria tu nombre, Señor. Chapter 24 and verse 3. Esto es lo que dice la palabra de Dios. Y estando él sentado en el monte de los olivos, Los discípulos se le acercaron aparte, diciendo, Dios, dinos, ¿cuándo serán estas cosas y qué señal habrá de tu venida y del fin del siglo? See, this is the purpose, the strategy, the plan, everything that is going on. Excuse me. And he said upon the Mount of Olives,
yes.
Disciples came unto him privately, saying, tell us, when shall these things be? What shall be the sign of thy coming and of the end of the world? Respondiendo Jesús les dijo, mirad que nadie os engañe. And Jesus answered and said unto them, take heed that no man deceive you.
Amen.
See, he took off their horse. Mm-hmm. Everything was so awesome. Everything sounded good, felt good, looked good. But at the end of the day, it did not conform to God's will.
That's right.
See, and everything is still out there every day, the same strategy.
Mm-hmm.
And it's really, really powerful. It's this. Take heed that no man deceive you.
Amen.
Versículo 5. Porque vendrán muchos en mi nombre diciendo, yo soy el Cristo, y a muchos engañarán. Y oiréis de guerras y rumores de guerras. Mirad que no os turbéis, porque es necesario que todo esto acontezca, pero aún no es el fin. And you shall hear, say, many shall come in my name, saying, I am Christ, and shall deceive many. And you shall hear of wars and rumors of wars, and that ye be not troubled, for all these things must come to pass, but the end is not yet.
Yes.
Versículo 7, presenta, porque se levantarán nación contra nación, reino contra reino, y habrá pestes y hambres, y terremotos en diferentes lugares. For nation shall rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom, and there shall be famines and pestilences and earthquakes in diverse places. It is important that we keep our families within the ranch, within the presence of God, within the hedge of protection, within our prayers for such a time as
yes,
this. We've got an environment that is changing rapidly, and we know and hear so much hatred, so much this and so much that. But praise be to God that we're going to have to head back to the ranch. If there's anybody here that has decided to take off and say, oh, you know what, just, there's many out there that we know, maybe even in our families, they're riding high in their horse thing. And it feels they're, what does it say, galloping and just feel great about themselves.
Yeah.
It feels good.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, the enemy is so deceiving.
Mm-hmm.
He wants us back.
Yeah.
He wants us. The Word of God says that he who dwells in the secret place of the
Most High
shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty.
Yeah.
La palabra de Dios dice que el que habita el abrigo del Altísimo morará bajo la sombra del Omnipotente. Versículos 10, versículo 9, perdón. Amén. 8, right here. Y en todo esto será el principio de los dolores. Entonces, versículo 9, os entregarán a tribulación. Y os matarán y seréis aborrecidos de todas las gentes por causa de mi nombre. Muchos tropezarán entonces y se entregarán unos a otros. Y unos a otros se aborrecerán. Y muchos falsos profetas se levantarán y engañarán a muchos. Versículo 12. Y por haberse multiplicado la maldad, el amor de muchos se enfriará. Mas el que persevere hasta el fin, este será salvo. All this is the beginning of sorrows. Verse 18, they shall deliver you up to be afflicted, and they shall kill you, and you shall be hated of all nations for my name's sake. And there shall many be offended, and shall betray one another, and shall hate one another. And many false prophets shall arise, and shall deceive many. And because iniquity shall abound, the love of many shall wax cold. But he that shall endure unto the end, the same shall be saved. See, we're in this very critical moment.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's very important that we discern.
Yes.
Because there are those thinking that false prophets and everything arising. There's
yes.
those things that want to lure our families, lure our brothers and sisters, our sons and our daughters away from the presence of God.
Mm-hmm.
Away in those principles, those values, from the plan of salvation.
Yes.
To destroy, to steal, kill, and destroy.
Mm-hmm.
But we're going to have to persevere. Yes. We're going to have to hold tight and say, nothing, no weapon that is formed against us shall prosper. See, we better declare it and we better decree.
Amen.
Hay que declarar y decretar que ninguna arma forjada contra nosotros prosperará.
Yeah.
Glory to God. See, many, and see, this is the thing that he's doing, is that there's all this going on. Mm-hmm. See, many will deceive. Many are going to say, hey, just, you know, you've got all that money, bring your checkbook.
Mm-hmm.
Come back this way. Let's have a heck of a life out here without God. But praise be to God. And in closing here today, 2 Timothy verse 4, 2 de Timoteo, capítulo 4, Gloria a Dios por su palabra, por todo lo que está haciendo poderosamente. All that God is doing in a mighty way because he loves us.
Amen.
2 Timothy chapter 4 and verse 2. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And it's all right to say hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest in every way. You know, all over the town.
Yeah.
And you know that the enemy will flee. The strongholds will be broken.
Yes.
People will be loosened.
Amen.
Be free from depression.
Yes.
Capítulo 4, versículo 2. Aquí en concluir la palabra dice versículo 2. Que prediques la palabra que instes a tiempo y fuera de tiempo. Redarguye y reprende, exhorta con toda paciencia y doctrina. Porque vendrá tiempo cuando no sufrirán la sana doctrina, sino que teniendo comezón de oír, se amontonarán maestros conforme a sus propias concupiscencias, y apartarán de la verdad el oído y se volverán a las fábulas. Pero tú, ser sobrio en todo, soporta las aflicciones, haz obra de evangelista, de padre, de misionero, de pastor, de todo. Dice, haz obra evangelista, cumple tu ministerio. We are ministers unto our children. We are prophets, we are missionaries. Everything that we continue to speak over our children, over our families. Right here, it says right here in closing, preach the word, be instant in season and out of season.
Yes.
Reprove, rebuke, exhort with all long suffering and doctrine.
Yes.
For the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine.
Yeah.
See, the moment that we drop the ball,
they
jump on that horse and they take off.
So
those are the things that we have to take into consideration.
Mm-hmm.
The moment that we be conformist to the world.
Yeah.
Then it causes a ripple effect in our homes. It's all right. My parents are doing it.
Mm.
Remember that old commercial for marijuana with the commercial? Well, the son is like, well, I saw you doing it, Dad, or something like that. It's like, well, everything has a ripple effect, you know.
Mm.
It's the curses and the generational curses.
Mm-hmm.
Well, the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine,
right.
But after their own lust shall they hear to themselves teachers having itching ears. And they shall turn away their ears from the truth, and they shall be turned unto fables.
Mm-hmm.
But wash thou in all things, endure affliction, do the work of an evangelist, of a father, of a mother, of a prophet, of a teacher. Make full proof of the ministry.
Yes.
Praise be to God.
Amen.
You know, you wanna, you know, it's just, you know, I just like, oh my God, you know, I just, you know, when no matter if. You know, we step on some toes. It's all right to step on some toes.
Yeah, God is.
It's all right. You know, I'll give you the opportunity. If I get out of line, step on my toes today. And in closing today, I want to say praise God.
Amen.
One of us, you know, just think about this out here in the land. This message, men fall back at the ranch. What are we doing?
Mm.
Are we praying or are we leaving the case set us and on? Whatever will be by Doris Day, everything's fine.
Yeah.
You better stay focused on the word.
Yes.
For such a time as this, I want to thank you that God is moving in a mighty way.
Yes, he is.
God bless each and every one of you. Ask for your prayers.
Thank you, Lord.
Ask for your prayers because I've got daughters as well. Say, Lord, I ask your hedge of protection over them. Your blessings, the one that is in Blackland right now, the Air Force, the one is in Tucson. And continue to pray for me. Just pray for one another.
Yes.
We all got to receive the blessings and stay within the ranch here, within the blessings of God.
Amen.
God bless you in a mighty way. Gracias por su invitación. Thank you for your invitation. Love you all and God bless you. And I want to thank Pastor Jose and Patricia and all of you for having me here.
Amen.
And if I yell too much, tell me to lower my voice.
Yeah.
God bless you.
Amen.
God bless you.
Amen.
God bless you.
Oh, praise God.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Lord.
Appreciate it.
Praise God.